To write research article with correct English or writing research article without any grammatical mistakes plays a very important role as far as research article acceptance or publication is concerned. Sometimes we approach some consultancies, though charges very heavily, and as a result, in today's video, we'll be discussing about some softwares or grammar checking software. We'll compare all these softwares and we'll decide the optimum softwares or best effective, user-friendly and obviously budget-friendly software so that you can make it use for your research article or for your thesis. Hello everyone, welcome back to the Chennai My Research Support. So friends, whenever we'll submit research article to any journal, there are basically two stages in that a research article can be rejected. First is preliminary stage and second is revision stage. In preliminary stage, there are basically four important reasons due to that our manuscript can be rejected. First is obviously simple reason, formatting requirements or formatting guidelines. If our manuscript, submitted manuscript is not following the formatting guidelines for that particular journal, then your manuscript can be rejected. Second is language. If we have used improper language, if there are some mistakes, maybe grammatical mistakes, then also our manuscript can be rejected. Third reason is novelty of the work. And fourth is theme of that particular journal. This third and fourth point, due to this third and fourth point, your manuscript will be directly rejected. If your submitted manuscript do not suit to that particular journal's theme, then your manuscript will be directly rejected. And if the journal editorial team feels there is no any novelty in your work, due to that also your manuscript will be directly rejected. But in case of first two points, few journals might give you a second chance to resubmit the manuscript with corrections. But now onwards, we'll be emphasizing on this second point, that how to remove the grammatical mistake from your research article or from your thesis. Before moving toward this software, I would like to discuss how to identify a perfect grammar checker, which are the different points we need to look into. See, there are some basic functions like spelling, grammar and punctuations, and there are also some advanced functions. Those have been written here. So the best grammar checking softwares should stand to perform all these functions. So as you can see here, spelling, your grammar checker should be able to correct a spelling. Then grammar, if there is any grammatical mistake, it is show instead of showed, you can use this. Then if there is a mistake with the punctuation, then also you'll be able to correct it. Then in advanced functions, fluency, as you can see here, instead of do, the better word that we can use is make. Then readability, as you can see here, if you have written a sentence, but that complete sentence is wrong, then the grammar checker will be able to convey that you need to rewrite the same sentence. Then word choice will be having few similar words. Instead of very happy, you might use thrilled, pleased, daily, delighted, etc. Then the next point is plagiarism detection. In many grammar checking softwares, you will get this point. But this is not at all effective. I'll strongly recommend you to use Turnitin software for checking plagiarism. This is not at all effective, means if your plagiarism of your manuscript is 40%, then this grammar checking softwares may give you 10% plagiarism or 12% plagiarism. So for that, basically many journals, many universities opt to use Turnitin software, or may sometimes they opt to use Urkun software. Then inclusive language. If you have used any sentence or few words, couple of words, those can be, or there might be a possibility that those can be replaced with the best possible words. So in this way also you should get the replacements. Formality level. Sometimes we make this mistake and we use informal word. In those cases also the grammar checker should be able to correct it. And that if additional advanced corrections, if any. So these are the important points that every grammar checker should have, or these are the important functions the grammar checker should perform. And now we'll see the list of free softwares and the list of paid softwares, and along with we'll also take one example, we'll take one paragraph, we'll check this paragraph by using a freeware software, and then we'll go for checking the same paragraph by using paid software or subscribed software or premium software. And you will get the difference, that what is the difference between free softwares and subscribed our premium softwares, and you will be able to make your choice that whether you have to go for freeware software or whether you have to go for premium software.
As you can see, these are the free grammar checking softwares, and these are the free and paid grammar checking softwares. Means all of these softwares are having their free versions and they are also having their paid versions. In free versions, we'll be having a deficiency of some features, whereas in paid versions, you'll be getting a full feature that we already talked about. So if you're talking about the free versions, then there is a Scribens, Reverso, Grammar Check, Grammarix, and small SEO tools. So if you have to at all prefer the free version, then I will recommend you to go for Scribens. But if you compare free versions with these softwares, paid softwares or premium softwares, then I will definitely recommend you to go for these premium softwares. So you'll be having here in premium softwares also, you'll be having many options like Grammarly, Quillbot, ProWritingGate, White Smoke, Ginger and Language Tool. There are many, but I have mentioned few of the important softwares. See, Grammarly is the best choice. I can rate a very high for this Grammarly because of the accuracy. You can see here. See, the Grammarly is having around 86% accuracy, 16 plus billion database. It is having a really huge database, 140k word limit, and number of devices. If you are going for the business accounts rather than premium accounts, then you might be, or the cost is even more than this, but you will be getting a number of devices. You can register with the number of devices. But the most important disadvantages with this Grammarly are, first is, it can be only used for English language, and it is a little bit of higher priced as compared to some other softwares. So the Grammarly is always best. We can go for Quillbot. It will be a little bit of less amount for the subscription. ProWritingGate, White Smoke. See, if you are writing your research article or thesis which is not in English language, then definitely you can go for White Smoke. It can be used to check the grammar in 55 languages by using this White Smoke. Ginger is again inexpensive grammar checking software or grammar corrector if you compare it with the Quillbot or Grammarly and Language Tool. But the effectiveness of all this software or the correctness of all this software is less as compared to Grammarly. So if you are having the at all choice that you can go in for the paid softwares, then go for Grammarly software. So coming to the conclusions, you'll find this. See, if you are looking for easy to use all round option, look no further than Grammarly. But ProWritingGate and White Smoke is also the best alternatives at providing style corrections. You'll be having different languages with the help of this White Smoke, and best style correction with the help of this ProWritingGate also. And avoid using Grammar Check and Grammarix, because these two softwares are the middleman. Grammar Check seems to be a side build from embedded Grammarly software. So skip the middleman and use Grammarly directly. Now we'll take one example. We'll just check one paragraph with the help of free software. We'll consider checking paragraph with the help of small SEO tools, and we'll also check the same paragraph with the help of Grammarly, so that you will be able to understand what is the difference between checking your manuscript or research article with free softwares and paid softwares. See, small SEO tools is the web platform you have to search, small SEO tools. Then you will find article rewriter, word counter, grammar checker, spell checker, etc. So now we'll consider this example, grammar checker. So here you have to paste the paragraph or the words, those you need to check against grammar. So I'll be considering this paragraph. So I'm just copying this paragraph and pasting in this interface. And now you have to click on this button, check grammar. So you'll be getting the mistakes if the paragraph is having. So now you can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, around 4 grammatical mistakes have shown by this software. However, if you are using और चेकिंग द सेम पैराग्राफ यूजिंग द ग्रामरली सॉफ्टवेयर. यू विल सी हियर ग्रामरली एक्सटेंशन इज एडेड टू द माइक्रोसॉफ्ट वर्ड. सो हाउ टू जस्ट गो टू दैट एंड यू हव टू सी द करेक्शंस. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Around 13 mistakes, grammatical mistakes, I've shown with the help of this Grammarly software. So this is the difference, that the accuracy and even accuracy replacements of words is again a very important. So this will be giving your formal words, informal words, unlike the free softwares. And here also you can compare free softwares and premium softwares, the difference between free and premium. The free softwares are only able to correct the spelling, grammar, or maybe punctuations. However, all these advanced functions that we'll only get in case of premium, that these functions we already discussed. So in this way, the effectiveness of premium softwares is always better. And if you compare the premium softwares, then definitely I will suggest you to go for Grammarly premium accounts. Skillbot is also good, but as per my experience, the effectiveness of Grammarly premium software is a little bit better than Skillbot. So this is my personal opinion. You may be having your opinions about these different softwares. So a little bit discuss about these Grammarly premium accounts. So this is the website of Grammarly, where you will get to know about the things can be done with the help of Grammarly. In case of email support also, you can use Grammarly. You can add extension to the Chrome. Then maybe Messenger, Outlook, Gmail, etc. And if you're scrolling down, then here you'll get to know about Grammarly Premium. You have to just click on it. And here you will get to know about the plans. See, Grammarly Premium is also, or Grammarly Simply is also available freely, but it only used for checking grammar and spelling checks and conciseness. However, there are many other functions like readability, vocabulary, general specific, plagiarism detector, and then there are many advanced features also that we cannot use with the help of these free softwares. And these are the plans, Grammarly prices. Monthly it costs us $29. This is a very high amount. If you are going quarterly, again this is very high amount. And this annual subscription, we can go for this annual subscription, but it also cost, see, this quarterly subscription is billed as one time payment, and this annual subscriptions will be billed as a one time payment. In that case, we'll need to pay $11 a month, but we have to pay the bill yearly. That means we need to pay $139. So this is again a very high amount. As we have seen, Grammarly premium accounts cost us very high, around $130 to $140 a year. But in that, we'll get full features. Means we'll be getting extensions for Microsoft Word. We'll be getting extensions for Chrome. Means while writing emails, if you need Grammarly support, in that case also it is possible. But this is the most important point. If you are a researcher, if you are writing research article, or if you are writing thesis, then we only require Grammarly for Microsoft Office or Microsoft Word. Means if you are getting the Grammarly premium accounts with full features, means if you require Grammarly premium for Microsoft Office, Grammarly premium for Chrome extensions, then probably you need to pay a little bit higher amount. But if you are taking this Grammarly premium for Microsoft Word also, or Microsoft Office only, then you will get it in reasonable price. So if you need any help in getting this Grammarly premium accounts in a reasonable price, then my email ID is there in the video description. Please write me an email, so I'll definitely help you. As I told, you will not be getting an extension to Chrome in these types of Grammarly premium accounts. But if you need Grammarly support while writing your emails, then simply you can write your email. You can just copy that text into your Microsoft Word, where you will be able to correct it, and you have to again copy that into your email body, and you will be able to send it. So that function can also be done with the help of this Grammarly premium accounts with Microsoft Office. We'll take one example so that you can better understand the working of this Grammarly premium accounts with Microsoft Office. So this is a Microsoft Word where I have added a Grammarly extension, and this can be called as Grammarly premium account with Microsoft Office or Microsoft Word. So along with this drop down menus, you will get this Grammarly as a separate tab. As you can see here, you will be having different options like close Grammarly, adjust goals, all issues like correctness, clarity, engagement, delivery, etc. You will be able to check plagiarism also. You can get expert writing help or style guide. So you will be basically in this Grammarly software, your words will be highlighted with different color lines, as you can see here. See, the red line indicates if only you have to just click on it, so this word is wrong. Internal engine, combustion engine are made, so I have to add engines instead of engine, so I have to just click, this word will be replaced. So this red line indicates there is a mistake, means correctness, this option. However, this blue line indicates clarity, means if you click on this blue line, then own creates a tautology, means own is not a proper word. Then green line indicates you have to click on it, so it indicates instead of this important word there are certain similar word or same kind of word that you can replace, like critical, essential, crucial, etc. So in this way you can best select the word which is most suited for your writing style. So in this way you'll get the interface of this Grammarly Premium with Microsoft Office Word.
So friends, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you like this information and video, and importantly, please do not forget to subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon to get latest research updates. We'll see in my next video. Bye bye.